I'm gonna make this video fast because I'm tired and I'm going to bed. My grandma could walk through the door any second, so I'll minimize this and I'll just keep the video going because I don't want to redo it. Today I saw my friend. I won't say his name. Will not disclose his name. So he told me not to give so much information out on YouTube because anyone can steal it. I already knew that. But I don't listen very much. I do listen. I do take in everyone's opinions. I just don't always agree with them. I don't tell people that unless they try to force their ideas on me. My friend never does. He's a good friend. Really good friend, actually. Anyways, that's not what I'm here to talk to you about. He showed me a few things today that I do agree with, but they're just... He showed me a bunch of demonic possession people. And whenever I see demonic possession people, I always think of what could be the logical reason behind it. And naturally, the reason our society is so involved in demonic things, in angels, and God, is because Zionists, which are the people who control our media and everything that happens in our society, how people act, is controlled by Zionists who worship Satan. And that's not a joke. Zionism is Luciferium, or however the fuck you say that. And they put Satanism in the media. They put... which makes the people paranoid. And then they start talking about the Bible. And they just... everyone gets paranoid. So whenever they see something like a guy on a new drug or something that the government is obviously testing out. And they're saying, the devil's inside of me. The devil's inside of me. And nothing's hurting him. You know, certain drugs take away pain. You know, certain drugs do that, and they give you super strength. Certain drugs do that. And the certain guys that were on YouTube, that were in the news articles, that were supposedly controlled by demons and killed people, and certain ones couldn't feel pain. Other ones just killed people. And I don't know about those people. I can't explain those people. Some people, I seriously think... it is the goddamn media that is doing this to people. There is so much Illuminati shit in the media nowadays that how can you avoid it? If you read into all the Illuminati bullshit so much that you will fucking become paranoid. I almost became paranoid before, but then I stopped looking at all that bullshit and... I was just like, sorry, I need to stretch. I'm really tired. I had a long day. But yeah, they showed me a bunch of things. They showed me conspiracy theorists, YouTube channels. There was one where a guy found a real live werewolf in like Arizona or New Zealand. I think it was New Zealand. And it looked seriously like it couldn't be a costume because the legs were all weird. There is a video of a fallen angel and it was creepy as fuck. With special effects now exist, like there's an on-camera video of someone teleporting. It's an old video, but it's a game trailer and it looks so real that people believed it, and conspiracy theorists said it's an angel, and this one is new, and no one can explain it, just like the angel one. But eventually, it will come out, and someone will explain it. But in this day and age, like now, people are so fucking paranoid. And the more and more you dig into this shit, the more paranoid you be. About 2 days ago, I was super fucking paranoid. You know what happened today? I met a Zionist. Full-fledged. You know what? This woman, she was the nicest woman in the world. You want to know why? She wanted information from me. You know what? I think I knew you. This is exactly what she said to me. I think I knew you. I'm an ex-teacher, and I swear, you were one of my students. I did not know that bitch. I did not know who she was. But you know what? No one is ever nice anymore. She was being nice. I didn't care if she was an undercover agent or something. I didn't give a shit. She was a nice person. Even if you're fakely being nice, I don't care anymore. No one is nice anymore. I'm just like, she's fucking talking to me. We're not fighting. We're getting along. Who gives a fuck? I don't care if she's being... Who gives a fuck? Who fucking cares? She's not fakely listening to me. She's responding to me like a person. She's a person. So anyway, she was asking me all the questions. She was conversing with me of all the things I've been talking about on my YouTube channel and my life. And she did the typical psychology thing. I was a teacher at your school. What was that school? What was that school? It was. And you do that in psychology. It's a social engineering trick. You stall until the other person answers your question. So she did that twice with my school and my elementary school and my high school, and where I lived in the past. Which, with that information, if she already knew all my information, it wouldn't matter if I told her. So I told her anyways. What is she going to use that for? I mean, if she had my file, or if she had something, she could just look at it. I mean, there's nothing else she could use it for. So, I didn't mind talking to someone who was nice. It was good. I don't care. There are no nice people left in the world almost. Everyone's a self-absorbed dickhole. And I really mean that. So, we were walking, and she was talking about all the things I like, pretty much. She obviously knew. She obviously read a file on me or something. And I'm not being paranoid at all. She knew everything about me. It was fucking weird. But that's not the first time that's happened. Someone, all of today, I mean, my friend is twice as paranoid as me, but I don't know why we shouldn't be. Weird things always happen in our life. My dad is never like that. My dad is like, oh, everything just happens. He doesn't ask questions. He doesn't worry about anything. This happens for this reason. It's just like, oh no, that happens. It's like, sometimes you have to ask why. You have to. Why does this person know everything about me? Sometimes you have to be a tiny bit paranoid to be safe. You can't always just be all holly jolly and comply with everyone. It doesn't work that way. So sometimes I'll just be nice, comply with them like I don't know what they're talking about, like I'm not aware. Because that makes them think like they're in control. So they think that they're manipulating you, but really you're manipulating them. Yeah. So, when we were walking, I asked her where she's going. She said, I'm going home. And I said, cool. She said, where are you going? And I said, I'm just going to my friend's house. I didn't say his name. Here's the weird thing. I asked her what her zodiac sign was. She told me her zodiac sign. She asked me what mine was. I said, I am a And I don't care if I admit this. What use will this be to anyone? I am a Gemini sun. I'm an Aquarius moon. And I'm a Leo rising. And... No, yeah, Leo rising. And... Seriously? What the fuck are you going to do with anyone's zodiac sign? You just have to be super fucking paranoid to think someone can do anything with your zodiac sign. So, she somehow knew this, and she brings up, of course, out of all the zodiac signs, after I tell her Leo, oh, I have a lot of friends that are Leos. Well, guess what? The friend I was visiting today is a Leo. And he's my friend. So that's kind of funny that she brings up that she has a lot of friends that are Leos. Out of all the signs that she can mention that are her friends, she picks Leo. Yes, if you heard that, I farted. Also, it's hilarious that she said she just came from the gym and she asked me if I go to the gym. I just said yes, but I didn't tell her what gym I go to. Because things like that are important. Things like that. Because then they can stalk you at the gym you go to. And I really mean that. When someone is way too nice. There was a girl when we went to the grocery store, my friend and me. The worker. She ran up to me. And she's like, hi, how you doing? How's your shopping going? You need anything? A worker wouldn't do that. You gotta notice things. If you can't notice things, you won't notice things like that. The worker just fucking jumped near us. Like, almost jumped. And she's just like, hi! What do you need? Things like that in my life. If I'm ever curious about something, too curious... Things like that will happen. People will get ultra friendly for no reason. No reason. And I'll just be friendly back. I'll be like, why be mean? I mean, my friend, I'm paranoid when things like that happen, but I don't want to show it. I don't want to be, my friend told me I have to be on alert. I have to be aggressive with, I mean, bad shit has happened to me in my life because of these things. But you know what? I learned from my mistakes. But still, I'm not a mean person. I mean, I'm a brutally honest person and I have no filter. But I'm a loving person. I'm a humanitarian. Like Hitler. Hitler was a humanitarian. But no, really, if I see a bunny dying, I'll cry. If I see any animal dying, I'll cry. But if it's dead already and it's just meat, I'll eat it. Because when it's meat, it has no emotions. It's dead. Stupid ass vegans. It's dead. And not eating meat is not going to save any animals. You retards. The FDA controls all of that. The higher-ups control all of that, and they're rich, and you are not. So you are not going to change anything. They control all of that. You control nothing. So stop thinking not eating meat and turning pale is going to change anything. You're just retarded as fuck. Just like liberals, if you think shouting something enough is going to change anything, it is not. The higher-ups control everything, so if you think you're making a difference, you are fucking stupid. By the way, you gotta sit in reality and not in Wonderland and notice what's happening in the world. The Zionists control everything. Let me just tell you what a Zionist is. It is a cult run by the richest families in the world. And they pay the Supreme Court, they pay the movie industry, they pay every single rich thing in the world to be Zionists. They pay them. And that's what some weird Christians will refer to selling your soul to the devil, because they're joining the Illuminati, which is Zionism, and they're working for the Illuminati. That's what all that shit is. That's why you see movie stars go like this. That's why you see them go like this. That's why, because the richest families in the world are Satanists. If you don't believe me, look up some images. Look up some images of what they do at their parties. Just look that shit up. It is fucking weird. They wear masks, they put goat heads over their heads, real live animal stuffed goat heads. They put them over the woman's heads. It's fucking weird. They are Satanists. If you don't believe me, I am not a religious person. I am a logical, science, more science type person. I'll look at the science logical version first, and then look at the religious part. And if they mix, cool, but I always want to find a reason for something before I can find an interpretation. Because someone can read a part of the Bible and say, oh, it means this. Then you go to another YouTube video and they can say, oh, it means this. And then you're like, wait, that guy just said it means this. And that guy just said it means this. What does it mean? Because the Bible is open for interpretation, just like what my book will be for. So people can argue because it's open for interpretation. It can mean anything. It's up to you. Yep. So, the last thing I want to say is about the richest families in the world, the Rockefellers and the Rothschilds. I get it mixed up of which one's richer. I'm pretty sure it's the Rothschilds. What I learned yesterday, I'm going to end this by 20 minutes. What I learned yesterday is that incest, and I talk about incest here because the Rothschilds do incest because they're a royal family. At least they consider themselves a royal family because they get about $6 billion a year in holdings. Yeah, they get your taxes. They own the Federal Reserve. You are giving your money to random people because the Federal Reserve is not federal. It is a privately owned bank. And you are giving your money to them, you fucking stupid Americans. I mean that 100%. They are a private bank and you're giving your money, your taxes, to random people or rich family. And they're laughing at you because you're dumb. Okay. Now that we got that settled, they do incest because they want to keep the royal genes in the royal family. I wanted to look up incest because I wanted to know, does it really cause birth defects? No, incest does not cause birth defects. The reason they say it causes birth defects was because if one person in your family has liver disease problems, and if the brother has liver disease, and the sister has liver disease problems, the baby will come out, if they have sex, with really bad, high chances of liver disease. If both sides, the brother and the sister, both have perfect genetics, the baby will have extremely perfect genetics. It goes like that. If both brother and sister are extremely healthy, the baby will be extremely healthy. So I'm guessing, since they're a billion-dollar family, the babies that the incest they're popping out are very healthy. So you can't, you, I'm not saying to do it, I'm, well, this isn't going to end by 20, but it will. I'm not saying to do incest, but if you do, you're not going to have a messed up child unless you're really unhealthy. If, like, if you have a lot of health defects, if you, if cancer runs in your family and you do incest, then cancer is going to double because you're mixing cancer with cancer instead of meeting someone else who has good genes and you're cutting it down a little bit. Why did I wonder this? I wondered this because when I saw the Rothschilds, I wondered, how are they not having deformed kids? And also I wondered, and this is a true fact, black families and black people often do incest. And I'm not doing saying that as a racist thing, and I could, and I wouldn't care, but I'm not saying it to be mean, honestly. It's a true fucking fact. And you know what? White people can do it too. Indian people can do it too. Asians, yeah, they can. Any race can do incest. But black people do it more. You can disagree with me. Put your angry comments in the comments box below. But just saying, when I look at black people, and I think, man, black girls look completely fine. And if they're, if I've heard so many people say there's incest in blacks, why do they look so fine? Well, one, black people have good genetics. They have really good genetics. And if they're doing incest with each other, they do have high blood pressure, though. That's a gene for blacks. So if they're doing incest, then their genes are going to not be that bad. I'm just saying, because you're mixing good genes with good genes. I mean, if two white brother and sisters had horrible, horrible genes, then they're going to have a horrible, horrible child. Just like, it's kind of genes. It just matters your genes. What problems you have with your genes. The brother has asthma. The sister has a chance of getting colon cancer. I don't know. The baby's going to be fucked completely. The brother is an athlete. The sister is a supermodel. They have a kid. That kid is going to be amazing. You get what I'm saying, right? You get it. Not trying to be creepy. Not creepy. It's just the idea of incest is completely wrong because someone made it wrong. That's all I'm saying. Just like jaywalking. We think jaywalking is bad because originally, when cars first came out, people were walking in front of them because there were no laws of, like, crossing. People were just walking with cars and getting run over. So jay was a bad word, so we called jaywalking a bad thing. And now to this day, we don't know why we call it jaywalking, and no one follows that rule anymore because we know not to walk in front of cars. We just walk when there are no cars and we cross the street. Jay used to be a bad word, so we called it jay. Now it's gone. So why do those stupid things that we believed before still exist? We gotta learn why and then learn from our mistakes and then fix them. Imagine that. Okay, goodbye. I hope I taught people some stuff, and now I'm going to bed. Have a great night and something.